the news tonight. Organized labor state protests who prepare Nigerians for nationwide strike. In business, German Chancellor Angela Merkel pledges 1 billion euro fund for investments in Africa. And on the foreign scene, United States President Donald Trump to end birthright citizenship. Good evening and thank you for joining the Super Screen TV flagship news reaching you from our studio here in the commercial capital, Lagos State. I am Kiruka Ibe, and now the news in full. The organized labor has asked President Muhammadu Buhari and the Minister of Labor, Chris Ngige, to fulfill the promise of 30,000 naira new minimum wage for faith or face a legalized industrial action across the 36 states of the Federation. The organized labor made their position known today during a peaceful rally to pre-inform Nigerians about their coming industrial action. And in the presidency, President Muhammadu Buhari says the federal government would take strongest measures possible to punish anyone found culpable in the latest killings in Kaduna State. The president made this known today during a condolence visit to the state. President Buhari was saddened that the recent tragic loss of lives and property in Kasuwan, Mangani, and the unrest around the state, demanding the end to such wanton killings. The president directed the Nigerian police force to remain vigilant in securing communities and diligent in prosecuting criminal offenses in the state. The president further commiserated with the government and people of Kaduna, as well as families who lost loved ones in the unfortunate incident. And the chairman, Independent National Electoral Commission, INEC, Mahmoud Yakubu, has advised journalists and election administrators from West African countries to undertake their various responsibilities with professionalism. Yakubu, who was represented by INEC Commissioner Mustafa Lekki, gave the advice at the opening of the two-day media workshop on the reporting of elections organized by ECOWAS Network of Electoral Commissions, ECONEC, in Abuja.
People will be looking up to whatever you report to mobilize them to be aware about what is happening. And also raise the issue of the challenges of social media in reporting, because the number of people these days use social media as their primary source of information. And we have seen a lot of discordant tunes, including instances of fake news, and including instances where you cannot really contextualize the source of the information. You cannot verify whether it is true or not. So that's why it's important that as we have this very important workshop with a number of major elections coming due in the region, that the reporters such as yourselves are built and they can discuss about the challenges and how to more effectively report so that the electorates are well informed and they're carried along.
Yakubu runs of ECONEC and INEC commitment to promoting peaceful, free, fair and credible elections in the sub-region.
We are a growing democracy in this part of the world. And we could see the challenge in a number of other countries, other democracies such as the US and Western Europe. So we cannot be an island unto ourselves. We need to find out more about it, engage it, and see how we can secure our own elections more effectively from interference of rogue, you know, international people who may want to disrupt the outcome of our election. So it's not beyond some of the things we need to discuss at this meeting to say, okay, what are the issues? How do we in sub-region be alert to it? What do we need to secure? Do we need to secure it more, you know, effectively? We know that electronic voting is creeping into our elections in various countries at various stages, so we need to be aware.
The INEC Commissioner Mustafa Lekki also emphasized the need for media practitioners to avoid past mistakes, insisting as the fourth estate of the realm, the media is expected to ensure transparency and accountability in the electoral process. The federal government has assured that the country is on the verge of total eradication of polio. The executive director of National Primary Healthcare Development Agency, NPHCDA, Faisal Shaibu, gave this assurance at the Expert Review Committee on Polio and Routine Immunization, ERC, in Abuja. Faisal also said government has employed trained health workers and mobile team to reach out to remote areas with geographical barriers to make vaccine accessible to children in order to eradicate polio outbreak again in Nigeria.
Between 2016
And the present time, this was in early months of 2018, actually, that we've seen a 10% increase in the routine immunization coverage. 10% might appear as if it's just marginal, but in the routine immunization space, it is unprecedented. Never before have you seen this kind of huge jump anywhere globally. This is tied to the kind of support that we've received from Mr. President, from the Honorable Minister of Health. We declared in 2017 a state of public health concern around the low routine immunization coverage. We set up coordinating centers at the national level, at the states and local government areas to ensure that there's intense program management, there's accountability, there's proper coordination of a routine immunization program.
Away from that, members of the Islamic movement in Nigeria, IMN, also known as Shahid, has clashed with soldiers in Yanya area of the Federal Capital Territory. According to reports, the trouble started when soldiers at a military checkpoint prevented the Shahid procession from coming to Abuja. The military said troops and police repelled the attack by Shahid members, who also fired weapons, threw stones and Molotov cocktails. You will recall that Shahid leader El Zazaki was arrested in 2015 after his members had a confrontation with the convoy of the Chief of Army Staff, Lieutenant General Tukur Burutai, in Zaria and Kaduna State. Since the arrest and detention of El Zazaki, his followers had organized a series of protests in some cities in the country calling for his release. And while the Nigerians have been urged to contribute their quota to nation building by using their resources to affect the needy, this appeal was made by security experts at a social service event held recently in Lagos State.
Giving is an act of freedom through which donors or givers express their values by taking it upon themselves to improve the lives of men or women and by extension the world at large. Oftentimes, however, many attributes given to corresponding benefits and to other people, giving is seen as the responsibility to only philanthropists, especially when given to a group. Super Screen at this forum that brought together philanthropists on the Rotary sought the views of these prominent Nigerians on the act of giving.
Rotary is as a non-state actor, really. They are partners in progress in the enterprise of nation building and securing the nation. Because we're listening to all what they are doing, intervention in medical area, education, affordable health care, and I always said, let them extend it to farmers in the rural areas, because also part of a critical intervention, and youth arresting the hearts and mind of our recalcitrant youth who are prone to violence.
People should not be selfish. When you look at people like the Bill Gates, you look like Ford. You know, those are people, those are human beings who started foundations. Bill Gates, you know, he's one of the he's the richest man in the world. But, you know, just being rich is not so satisfying. But when you utilize your resources to positively impact others, then that is when it's fulfilling and that's when it's satisfying. So I would say that the rich Nigerians should come out. I know some of them might be scared to come out because when they come out, at times, they're, you know, because of this anti-corruption crusade, some of them tend to, you know, just go in their shell. But there are so many ways they can come out to help impact others.
Speaking with the man of the moment, Mustafa Loste, in whose capacity they are all gathered, he said giving must be voluntary and for the purpose of adding value and not for any form of gains.
I feel humbled, honored, and privileged to be the incoming president of Rotary, in which give a platform to be able to serve and support and add value to mankind. You see, when you are privileged to have something you can give to others, it goes a long, long way to me. I believe in putting people even before myself and even having a platform to be able to do much more. Rotary gave that platform and I really appreciate that. And also, not only that, I was also given privilege to lead people who are better than me, to be able to lead them, listen to them, take their advice, and make a final seal in the way forward in the direction of what we should do to add value.
Nation building, no doubt, is the responsibility of government, individuals, organizations, and other groups. It will only be right that each and every Nigerian rise up to the task of giving. This way, the country can be a better place.
Coming up on the news tonight, German Chancellor Angela Merkel pledges 1 billion euro fund for investments in Africa. There's more to come on the Business End just after the break. You welcome back. Now talking business, German Chancellor Angela Merkel has pledged €1 billion to incite businesses to invest in Africa as she urged the private sector to take a closer look at the continent's huge economic opportunities. Merkel said economic development requires not just government support, but also private investment. The creation of the fund announced during an investment forum in Berlin is aimed at getting small and medium-sized companies to grow their presence in Africa. Germany has been seeking to help boost economic development in Africa as it hopes better work prospects and living standards on the continent will help curb illegal migration to Europe. And still ahead, United States President Donald Trump to end birthright citizenship. There's more to come on the foreign scene.